Hello everyone, good morning. Maria Banga, Maria Banga chiming in from Douala, Cameroon. Maria Banga, you're psychotherapy specializing in mental health and relational wellness, right? Okay, so I do a segment. I used to do a segment on Facebook Live, and I really love it, titled Keeping It Real. You know, I love keeping things real in my life, and I use my personal experiences a lot. That's my purpose in life, right? To inspire, motivate, encourage people from all walks of life using my personal experiences. And you know, when people come for therapy, they're coming because something is not going on so well, and then they need help, you know, to move on, to face this situation, to deal with the situation. And when relationships are concerned, sometimes we are stuck because the relationship is not as healthy as we were hoping it would be. In other words, it's toxic. And I'm not excluded, you know. I was listening to Esther Perel, I think it was on Vogue 73 Questions with Esther Perel, and she said that therapy practice is a very lonely profession. Therapists are lonely people. Everybody looks up to you to help them, and people don't know that you're just an ordinary person and you can be going through the same thing that they bring to you. And sometimes you also need to go for therapy. You need to work with a therapist. Well, in my country, I'm still trying to figure out who are some other therapists I can kind of like work with and know that we are there for one another. In the meantime, I just, you know, do and listen a lot to people online, and I Google things a lot. I put things into practice in my own life. I get the results. I evaluate myself. I talk to people, and you know, I'm a very spiritual person too, so I get that feedback from my spirit too. One of the things I want to talk about today is taking a break and being ready to move on from that toxic relationship. Oh, toxic, it's on a scale, right? Nobody can say how toxic a relationship is to you. You are the only person who can say how toxic that relationship is to you. For me, a relationship where I'm not respected is a toxic one. A relationship where I'm treated just anyhow, it's a toxic one. A relationship where, so it depends. People have different opinions. Okay, fine. But if you know you are in a toxic relationship, you should take a break, or you should be ready to move on, or you should move on. I've been in different toxic relationships in my life. Not too long ago, I had to take a break from a relationship. One which was toxic, not the toxic some people might think, you know, the beating and everything. No, it's a long distance one. And the toxic here is being spoken to anyhow, being with, you know, people use some kind of words. I'm a very sensitive person. I am an HSP, highly sensitive person. So I also pay a lot of attention to what I say to people, because I don't know if they're sensitive as myself. You know, I don't want to be the cause of anybody's nervous breakdown, frustration, depression, and all of that. So I don't also take it when people, use some kind of words to me or say some kind of things. I've had to work a lot to filter all of those things out. And well, if I don't care about you, whatever you say also doesn't mean anything to me. But if it's a partner, you know, it's going to affect you, and you're going to be asking yourself questions. Is this relationship worth it in the first place or not? So this is the second time I am taking a break in this relationship, and the third time definitely is going to be the last time. So I don't know if this person knows it, but I think they are feeling it, because there's a way people can feel your energy in the decisions you take, in the way you make these decisions play out. Like, you take a break and then you're not quick to run back in by their first smiling or their first writing or their first flashing or their first all of that. Especially when you're not married to this person. Come on, you were living before this person came into your life. And so you're continually living. That relationship is not even about this person. It's about you wanting to be in that relationship. So it means that you should and can take yourself out of this relationship. It's not about the person blackmailing you and saying, how can you do this to me? No. It is about you doing what you want for yourself, what you deserve. And that's the word I use. I said, at this stage in my life, I don't deserve this kind of relationship. And so I took a break. You know, it doesn't mean that I shut them all out, but I did block them, for example, on WhatsApp. They had been the first person to even teach me how to block people or to block a partner. They blocked me on Facebook because they didn't want to be seeing all my activities on Facebook, and they were was living my life, having fun back home. What was I supposed to do? Sit back and be behaving like a widow or whatever you call it. Just be, you're out there. No, come on. I'll have fun. Do I know what you're doing out there? No, you know, that's something. Sometimes people want to control people, keep people in a state of despair and all of that. Why living your own best life out there? So I said no. And so when they blocked me on Facebook, I reached out to them. They didn't even tell me they were going to block me on Facebook, and then they did. So I was like, hey, okay, well, so since you've done this, then I am doing this. I mean, I don't think it's worth you having access to me or WhatsApp, and this thing is even kind of becoming inconsistent and everything. That's not what I want. And I did that. And after a while, well, they came back and fine. But recently, well, something came up again, and I was like, hey, you know, I didn't even tell them. I just blocked, and then, well, sent an email saying, well, email is the best you can have right now. And I'm not sure, you know, right now. So let's keep it at that. That is it. My mental health is very important. This person doesn't give me oxygen. That person, whoever it is in your life right now, is not your source of oxygen. And no matter what you have invested in this relationship, it doesn't matter. You must have learned a lot also about yourself in that relationship. You have also learned a lot about other human beings in that relationship. And then there is a big potential. You know, when you move on, you don't know what's waiting for you just around the corner. So sometimes you don't want to move on because you're like, oh, but what if? Now, why not think about the what if I just go and meet my real final soulmate after this relationship? What if it was my moving on that was going to open me to this possibility of becoming, you know, that career you had kept aside, whatever, all of those prospects? What if just moving on is actually going to let you start doing, you know, maybe baking, losing the weight or putting on some weight, sleeping properly, loving your children more, spending more time with your friends and family? That freedom, is it worth it? You know, I'm a relational wellness therapist. I work a lot with women in particular who are stuck in such toxic relationships, abusive relationships. And I'm like, it starts with you and it starts inside there. Once you get to that point where you realize that relationship is not about not hurting the man or the woman. It's not about, how can you do this to me? It's about, why shouldn't I do this to me? What do you deserve? I deserve so much, and I can give that to myself. I mean, I can put you there at arm's length and I say, hey, I need a break. And I think you too need that break. And so you're like, take all the time you want, or I give you 1 week, or I give you 1 month. And in that 1 month, you yourself decide whether, well, you're even open for any reconciliation, quote and unquote, or if you don't want to anymore, right? Okay, so if you're in such a relationship and you don't know what to do, and you're scared of taking a break or even moving on completely, if that is what it boils down to, well, therapy is a laudable option, right? Do not suffer in silence. Reach out and get the help you need. My handles are there. I know this is something that is still new in my country, Cameroon, and in Africa in general. People are still sometimes skeptical about therapy, but those who have given it a try, a lot of testimony. And I myself, I did get some therapy when I was out there in the West, and that's what really helped me and actually got me decide to divert. It's not like I stopped my legal practice altogether, but I am diverting and I'm finding much more pleasure in doing this. So until then, today's Friday, so have a funky Friday and God bless us all.